tonight on NewsWatch. Terrorist bombers attack a crowded bus station in Jerusalem.
Plus, unsafe to drink. Health officials say the water in Tokyo is too radioactive for children.
And 1 year later, will the Obama health care plan really become the law of the land? All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. For the first time in years, terrorists bombed the streets of Jerusalem. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. The bomb exploded at a crowded bus stop in central Jerusalem. One person is dead, nearly 40 others wounded. Officials there are calling it a terrorist attack. The blast could be heard throughout the city. CBN News Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell was there and filed this report just hours after the bombing.
Terror returned to the streets of Jerusalem for the first time in years on Wednesday.
I was working in an elderly lady who was seriously hurt. She wasn't breathing when I came here. She was laying right next to the bus. That's where the explosion happened. We were trying to revive her and stabilize her condition. We had another person right next to us who was terribly bleeding.
Police say the up to 4-pound explosive device was packed with shrapnel and hidden in a backpack. The blast damaged two city buses and forced the closure of the entrance to Jerusalem for more than an hour. Police officials say this is the first bus bombing in more than 4 years. The question many are asking is this could be a return to the kind of bus attacks that happened here in the city years ago. In those days, suicide bombers blew themselves up in buses and restaurants, killing hundreds and wounding thousands more. This was not a suicide attack, and police spokesman Mickey Rosenfeld said there was no specific warning of the attack.
We've heightened security in Jerusalem. We're continuing to assess the security situation after the explosion took place.
Jerusalem Mayor Ner Barkat said life would return to normal in his city despite the attack.
Every once in a while, people remind us who we're dealing with. A bunch of cowardice terrorists that put bomb in the middle of pedestrian walk and the people that were hurt are innocent people. You will very soon find out the city goes back to its normal life, and this is the best way to deal with terror, to show them they have zero gain.
The bombing follows an escalation in rocket and mortar attacks from the Hamas-controlled Gaza Strip on communities in southern Israel that is forcing the closure of schools for the next 2 days and has provoked Israeli military retaliation in which 8 Palestinians were killed. Rosenfeld said there was no connection.
What's taking place in the south and around the Gaza Strip is something that is being dealt with completely separate.
Still, some suspect Iran might be pushing Hamas to step up attacks against Israel, both on its southern border and beyond. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
And we want to talk more with Chris Mitchell from Jerusalem about this story. Chris, I know you've been on the phone with your sources in and around Jerusalem. What more are you finding out about this attack?
Well, the latest we heard from officials, Lee, has been Benjamin Netanyahu. He delayed his trip to Moscow by several hours, and he spoke to reporters at the airport just about an hour and a half ago. He said that Israel has a steel will and it would respond aggressively to what's happened. He's also met with Deputy Prime Minister Vilnius and his Chief of Staff, Benny Gantz, as well as the head of Shabak. So it's not certain exactly what kind of retaliation Israel will take right now, but certainly something will come.
Chris, as you mentioned in your report, the attacks a few years ago were suicide bombings. This one was not. Does that tell you anything about who may be responsible?
Well, nobody's claimed responsibility yet right now. And I just talked to one terror expert. He said that sometimes people do act alone. So that's one possibility. When we talked to the police spokesman earlier today, he said the investigation was still going on. It might not tell us one thing one way or the other, whether it was Hamas, Al-Aqsa Brigades, the fact that it wasn't a suicide attack. It was apparently a bomb that was attached to a telephone pole right near the bus stop and probably detonated by cell phone, by remote control.
The recent situation in Egypt, does that have anything at all to do, or are folks looking towards that as a possible link?
Well, they're looking to Egypt for one thing. Egypt's foreign minister earlier tonight said he warned Israel not to attack Gaza. I don't think, and it's kind of premature to see that the Egyptian government, per se, is linked to Hamas, supporting Hamas directly. But certainly there are elements within Egypt, specifically the Muslim Brotherhood, that is very sympathetic. In fact, they spawned Hamas Hamas is sort of the stepchild of the Muslim Brotherhood. So there is a link there. There's also a link with Iran that has been trying to get smuggle weapons into the Gaza Strip. Not only the kind of weapons we've seen in the past, mortars and rockets, but strategic weapons that could actually threaten Israeli naval ships on the Mediterranean.
Thanks, Chris. And I know you'll be keeping our viewers up to date on CBNNews.com. But thanks for your report tonight. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Lee.
The Obama administration is ready to hand over control of military operations in Libya. The president says that could happen within a few days, but there are questions about who will take that control and who will pay for it. It could be NATO, but one security expert tells the Washington Times that NATO is in complete disarray over Libya. Here at home, Obama is facing ongoing criticism from Republicans and Democrats for his handling of the action. Some say he shouldn't have gone to war in the first place, and others say he took too long and hasn't handled it well.
Breaking news this evening on gay marriage in California. A federal court has said it will not allow gay marriages in the state while it considers the constitutionality of the ban. California voters passed Proposition 8 in 2010. It defined marriage as a union between one man and one woman. You can follow this developing story at CBNNews.com and on tomorrow's 700 Club.
Christian groups are upset with Apple because the company pulled an app submitted by Exodus International. That's the Christian ministry which helps those struggling with homosexuality. In a written statement, Apple told CBN News the Exodus app, quote, violates our developer guidelines by being offensive to large groups of people. The president of Exodus says he's disappointed with Apple's decision to deny equal representation in the public square. Craig Parshall of the National Religious Broadcasters tells us this decision is iron-fisted censorship.
It's a bigger picture. You know, when these new media technology companies decide that they're going to pick and choose what opinions they'll allow on their platforms, that has dire consequences.
Parshall says if companies like Apple don't voluntarily respect the free speech rights of Americans, then they may have to be brought before the courts or Congress.
Today marks the one-year anniversary of President Obama's controversial health care law. Republicans want to repeal the law, and many Americans remain skeptical that the reform will actually benefit them. Charlene Israel has more.
In a grand celebration, the president signed his sweeping health care reform legislation into law.
After a century of striving, after a year of debate, after a historic vote, health care reform is no longer an unmet promise. It is the law of the land.
Parts of it have already been implemented, like allowing adult children to stay on their parents' insurance until they turn 26, prescription drug discounts for seniors, and insurance coverage for those with pre-existing conditions. As Obamacare turns 1 year old, the jury is still out on whether it will control soaring spending costs or improve health outcomes.
Most people have yet not seen a major change in their coverage or the cost of their coverage.
Congressional Republicans say the law costs too much and hurts small businesses.
A year later, it looks even worse than it did then, and that is really saying something.
Reducing costs was one of the key points the Obama administration made in its push for reform. But a new estimate by the Congressional Budget Office shows the cost of this bill has increased by $500 billion in the past year. Karen Minor Heard of the Virginia Tea Party Alliance told CBN News why.
First off, when they did the initial cost estimates, they used bogus numbers. You cannot add 30 million people to the rolls and then say we're going to cut costs.
Democrats continue to sell the bill as good for American consumers.
We believe very strongly that our health care system needed reform to increase the access that Americans have to health care.
Meanwhile, the Tea Party has this warning for newly elected congressional Republicans who don't fight the health care law.
If they don't stand up, we'll replace them in office. If they do not hold the line, that was what they were elected to do, to cut spending, and repeal Obamacare. If they don't do that, if they are perceived as being weak or vacillating or doing some kind of a bipartisan thing on a compromise that where there should be no compromise, then they will be replaced.
About two dozen states are suing the administration because they say the bill is unconstitutional. The case is expected to go to the U.S. Supreme Court. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Phil Kirpin is with Americans for Prosperity. He tells CBN News the new health care law saw many failures over the last year.
Premiums have gone up, not down, on average about $2,100 per family in higher premiums under the new law, with the carrier saying it's specifically because of the cost to them of complying with the new regulations. We've seen a lot of people lose their coverage when the president, of course, promised over and over again that if you like your plan, you could keep it. The official estimates from the Obama administration are that about 50% of folks will lose the plans they have now, and about 80% of small businesses will no longer be able to offer the plans they have now with the new grandfather regulations that have been put in. And they promised over and over again that we wouldn't have rationing of care. And then Obama put someone in charge of the Medicare program, Donald Berwick, who's an open proponent of rationing, who says he's romantic about the British healthcare system. And we've already seen some troubling things, like the FDA withdrawing approval for Avastin as a treatment for breast cancer, and the implications that that has in terms of the availability of care and rationing. And so I think we're already seeing many of the things that opponents of the bill warned about, and we're really not seeing the benefits we were promised.
And to see that entire interview with Phil Kirpin and hear if he thinks the bill will be repealed, go to our website, cbnnews.com.
Coming up, the loss of a legend. Hollywood loses one of the last great movie stars.
Attention investors, now is the time to protect your retirement accounts and investments.
Excessive government spending is devaluing the U.S. dollar, and high rates of inflation are coming. Gold has tripled since 2001, and some experts predict the prices will climb another 100%. Buy gold now, direct and wholesale, with United Gold Group. The demand for gold around the world is higher than ever. Foreign countries like China and India are buying up gold at record rates. Why? What do they know that you don't?
Call now and get your Gold Investors Kit absolutely free. Call in the next 5 minutes and receive The Secret to Owning Gold in Your Retirement Account, also absolutely free. Just call 1-800-758-5070. That's 1-800-758-5070.
This could be the most important call you make this year. United Gold Group, investing in America's future.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One-A-Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil. You'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
They go down real easy.
Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One-A-Day and not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-409-7339. That's 1-800-409-7339. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
Well, the price of oil is still climbing, more than $105 a barrel today. The fighting in Libya has something to do with that because it threatens oil supplies.
But we should have new sources of oil soon from right here in America, Mark Martin reports.
North Dakota's prairies and badlands have a peaceful beauty. But for many, what lies underneath this landscape is the real draw, or real play, as they say in the oil industry.
There's a tremendous amount of oil in the Bakken.
North Dakota, its neighbor Montana, and a part of Canada are home to what's known as the Bakken Formation, a massive area covering about 200,000 square miles. The United States Geological Survey estimates the American portion holds 3 to 4.3 billion barrels of undiscovered, technically recoverable oil. Unlike conventional wells, where the oil collects in a certain area, the oil in the Bakken is spread throughout shale rock, primarily over a large area.
These were here before, but our knowledge of them is not what it is now. The technology was not here before to develop these.
It most definitely is here now. Production in the Bakken jumped 50% in just the past year.
Here is the main hole where they're drilling for the oil. This drill pipe here goes 2 miles down into the ground
and then 2 miles over to extract the oil. It's a technique known as horizontal drilling.
Drilling down, then out. The horizontal drilling is opening up vast fields of oil once locked away in rock. That's helping to reverse a two-decade decline in the domestic production of crude. Companies are investing billions of dollars to drill for oil in North Dakota, Colorado, Texas, and California. Oil executives and analysts say in just 4 years, the new fields could yield as much as 2 million barrels of oil a day, more than the entire Gulf of Mexico produces now. And for North Dakota, that's great news for the state's economy.
What's happening here is so different than what's happening in the rest of the nation. I mean, we have rising property values. We have low unemployment.
Unemployment in North Dakota has dropped to the lowest level in the nation, 3.8%. That's far less than half the national rate.
Right now, the state has a budget surplus, and a lot of it's due to the oil activity in western North Dakota.
At a time when states face massive budget deficits, the shale oil boom has handed North Dakota a $1 billion budget surplus. And the hope is that increasing our domestic supply of oil will benefit the entire nation by bringing gas prices down and reducing our dependence on foreign oil.
Our appetite for energy is so big that it takes a lot of pieces to meet that need.
But it's a step in the right direction.
Sure. Sure, if it's developed and all of the environmental concerns are addressed.
Environmentalists are concerned that fluids or wastewater from the hydraulic fracturing, a process used to remove the oil from the shale, could pollute drinking water. The Environmental Protection Agency is investigating. But those concerns aside, the big oil fields here could help the U.S. cut its dependence on foreign sources by as much as half within 10 years. Mark Martin, CBN News, Dickinson, North Dakota.
The entertainment world has lost an icon. Actress Elizabeth Taylor died of heart failure this morning. Taylor was just 12 years old when she hit it big in the film National Velvet. And she made a successful transition to adult roles in films like Giant, A Place in the Sun, and Cleopatra. She won the first of three Oscars for Butterfield 8. Her life away from the camera made even more headlines. She was married 8 times. Former Virginia Senator John Warner and actor Richard Burton were among her 7 husbands. Taylor was surrounded by her 4 children when she died in a Los Angeles hospital. Her son Michael Wilding says she lived life to the fullest with great passion, humor, and love. Elizabeth Taylor was 79.
The doctor said to me, "Peggy, you don't understand. Pancreatic cancer is inoperable and incurable." And he says, "Well, Peggy, you've got 2 months to live." It was like he was telling me, go to the store. There was no compassion. Yeah, it was heartbreaking. My life was an hourglass. I was home laying on the couch, just dying. My sister Pam called the Cancer Treatment Centers of America. When I got there, I knew that I was gonna be cared for. I met with a doctor after the tests were done and said, "How long do I have?" And he looked at me and he said, "Peggy, we did a lot of tests on you. And I never saw one thing stamped on the bottom of your foot that said you were going to die in 2 months. You have no expiration date." And I thought, wow.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is unlike any other cancer hospital, full of hope, committed to your fight. We use every weapon, surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, nutrition, spiritual support, and mind-body medicine. We surround you with a real team, working together, all under one roof.
Each time I went back to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, I responded better. My tumors were shrinking, came back in September again, and they still couldn't see anything. I said, "You're kidding me." We'll see how it goes. We'll keep testing, but we can't see the tumors anymore.
Please call the number on your screen to speak with an oncology information specialist and receive a life-changing information kit and DVD packed with valuable information. Call now and learn about treatment options you may not even know exist.
It's really unbelievable how one doctor can tell me I have 2 months to live. And then I go to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America and they save my life. Hope is a mainstay. Hope is everything.
Don't give up. Your fight is our fight. Call Cancer Treatment Centers of America today.
Radiation from the disabled nuclear plant in Japan has reached Tokyo's water supply. Officials say the tap water is radioactive and unsafe for children to drink. Tests show it has two times the limit allowed for children. Infants are most at risk. The water is reportedly still safe for adults. The Japanese government is asking residents not to hoard bottled water.
A billboard advertising assisted suicide? This one in Boston is part of a nationwide campaign by the Final Exit Network. That group argues that assisted suicide should be an option for people with terminal illness or painful diseases.
It is possible today, even for people who have an irreversible illness and are suffering unbearably, to die in just a few moments, peacefully and painlessly.
I think it's dangerous to put up signs to encourage people to think of this as the option. There's no right to die. There's not a right to demand people to help you kill yourself.
Most states outlaw doctor-assisted suicide, but proponents have gained ground, with Washington State and Montana voting to legalize it last year.
Well, one of the Republicans who wants to replace President Obama in the White House is businessman Herman Cain.
Yeah, and he's usually not mentioned among the top potential GOP candidates, but David Brody reports that could change.
If you attend a Tea Party rally, don't be surprised to see the Herminator.
The American dream is under attack.
Cain is not a career politician. He's a Tea Party member, a Baptist preacher, and the former CEO of Godfather's Pizza. He calls himself the common sense candidate and tells CBN News Americans are fed up.
They are sick and tired of being sick and tired of the same old stuff, which is nothing ever gets solved.
Matt, will you please help me welcome Herman Cain.
Cain spends a lot of time in Iowa, the first stop in the 2012 presidential race. He's preaching a fiscal conservative message of repealing Obamacare, returning to the gold standard, and restructuring entitlement programs. One of his themes, emphasizing our country's Judeo-Christian heritage.
They don't like it when the president omits endowed by their creator from reciting the Declaration of Independence.
You believe that was intentional by the president?
I believe it was intentional because he did it three times. Now, with all of his teleprompters, how could you not put that in there? No, I believe it was intentional.
His message is starting to resonate. He won a recent Tea Party straw poll, and RedState.com, which is a major conservative website, declared him the winner of their reader poll.
I hadn't really heard Mr. Cain speak before, and I was quite impressed with his credentials.
Political strategist Ralph Reed believes Cain can gain traction, especially if Mike Huckabee and Sarah Palin do not get in the race.
If neither runs, I think you could look for a Herman Cain, a Rick Santorum, and maybe other candidates to really break off right tackle.
Cain has overcome bigger hurdles.
God has done some magnificent things with my life.
5 years ago, he was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer.
And I only had a 30% chance of survival. God said, Herman, not yet.
And he saw signs of God's involvement along the way, from the name of his doctor.
His name is Dr. Lord. I said, what? L-O-R-D? Yes.
To the nurse named Grace, who served him at the hospital.
A lady named Grace. My wife and I looked at each other, and I said, thank you, Lord. He's with me on this journey.
And the surgeon was a Christian from Lebanon and told Cain how he would remove all of the cancer with just one incision.
I'm going to start in your sternum, and I'm going to make an incision in the shape of a J. As in J-E-S-U-S? He said, yes, a Jesus cut.
And so Cain is still here, and the rest of the GOP field is about to encounter the Herminator.
And these candidates are going to have to deal with Herman Cain.
They're going to have to deal with Herman Cain.
David Brody, CBN News, Washington.
Great story, David. Media executives from around the world are in our nation's capital creating a global plan of action to help women news professionals. They're using the results of a new global report that surveyed hundreds of companies. The study found that in Nigeria, men and women earn equal pay. Sometimes women earn more. In the Middle East, men earn 3 to 5 times more than women. And in the UK, women are grossly underpaid in most high salary ranges, but participants are optimistic.
It takes a lot of commitment, and the word I would use here is passion. Passion in what you believe in, passion in what you think needs to be said, done, and passion in the fact that what you're doing is right. And of course, from where we come from, as I think everywhere else in the world, you need a supportive family.
The International Women's Media Foundation commissioned the two-year study.
Up next, a Florida pastor asks his congregation to help the homeless.
The doctor said to me, Peggy, you don't understand. Pancreatic cancer is inoperable and incurable. And he says, well, Peggy, you've got 2 months to live. It was like he was telling me, go to the store. There was no compassion. Yeah, it was heartbreaking. My life was an hourglass. I was home, laying on the couch, just dying. My sister Pam called the Cancer Treatment Centers of America. When I got there, I knew that I was gonna be cared for. I met with the doctor after the tests were done and said, how long do I have? And he looked at me and he said, Peggy, we did a lot of tests on you, and I never saw one thing stamped on the bottom of your foot that said you were gonna die in 2 months. You have no expiration date. And I thought, wow.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is unlike any other cancer hospital, full of hope, committed to your fight. We use every weapon, surgery, chemotherapy, radiation, nutrition, spiritual support, and mind-body medicine. We surround you with a real team, working together, all under one roof.
Each time I went back to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, I responded better. My tumors were shrinking, came back in September again, and they still couldn't see anything. I said, you're kidding me. We'll see how it goes, we'll keep testing, but we can't see the tumors anymore.
Please call the number on your screen to speak with an oncology information specialist and receive a life-changing information kit and DVD packed with valuable information. Call now and learn about treatment options you may not even know exist.
It's really unbelievable how one doctor can tell me I have 2 months to live. And then I go to the Cancer Treatment Centers of America and they saved my life. Hope is a mainstay. Hope is everything.
Don't give up. Your fight is our fight. Call Cancer Treatment Centers of America today.
A network news program recently turned the spotlight on the growing number of homeless children in Central Florida.
It was a heartbreaking story that inspired one Orlando pastor to do something.
I was had a conversation with a teacher who knows some of these hotels where these children are staying. We've already identified some places that we can begin that work.
Pastor David Uth asked members of First Baptist Orlando to help him raise $1 million to tackle the problem. Congregations at three services responded and left their pastor stunned when the final offering was counted.
This weekend, to the glory of God, the First Baptist Church of Orlando, or those who call this home, gave $5.6 million. Give him praise. Isn't that awesome?
Is awesome. The $5.6 million was raised in less than 24 hours.
That's a lot of money.
Man, that's
great
a lot of
church,
money.
Great church, great reputation.
You know, when you have a great cause like that, it just makes you want to dig deep and give what you can, and
that's right.
More power to them. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can email us your comments and questions at newswatch@cbn.com. We hope you'll join us next time.
Good night.